What's good YouTube? I'm back with another video, bruh. It's been a minute, I ain't gonna lie. But today I got a dread video for you guys. I'm kind of excited about this because a lot of you guys have been asking for me to, you know, kind of update you guys on what's going on. So last time you guys had that little update, I didn't have my hair dyed. But yeah, not much has changed too much. My hair's grown a little bit. Anyways, let's get straight into the video.
Put in a dark bitch, stop in a hard bitch, not a hard carpet in the car, yeah. Scar bitch, you're gonna bleed, my girl's cute.
So before we start, I just wanna give you guys a little disclaimer. Some of this stuff might not apply to you. So like, if it doesn't apply to you, don't get mad, cause it might not apply to you. But anyways, this is just stuff, you know, that I've experienced with my journey this time around. Some little things that I saw that were different, or, you know, just a little stuff, you know, let you guys know what's going on. Update. All right, so the first thing I really wanted to talk about was how many dreads you get. If you look at my hair and you're like, wow, that's a lot of dreads, right? But you don't really know how many it is unless like I were to count it or something. If I were to guess, I don't know exactly. If I were to guess, I would say it is about 400 dreads, you know, and it sounds like a lot. It really does. But like a little group like right here, an easy 100 dreads. I mean, it could be a cool thing or a bad thing. Some people like this mini dreads. I love this mini dreads. I mean, personally, I think it's cool and it's unique. But another thing is, like, when your hair gets like long, when you get a hand twist, it's gonna take so long. I can tell you that right now, it's gonna take forever. And you know, some people don't wanna wait for that. And I don't know, some people just don't like it. Cause you wanna get them all retwisted all at the same time. Cause if you don't, it's just not gonna look that great. You feel me? And so like having this many dreads, like I said, could be like a good thing or it could be a bad thing. Personally, I enjoy having this many dreads cause it's just, I don't know, I find it unique. So the reason why you get this many dreads, you know, real quick, let me get my sponge. So for those of you who don't understand why I have so many dreads, and honestly, I think there's ways to get around this, but here's my thinking and explanation for it. So here's the sponge that I use, right? When you look into it, you see how many holes there are, right? So they look decently big, but the part that separates it, that's where it kind of splits the hair. And so when you're twisting it, they get pretty small. So my thinking is, if you were to get ones with bigger holes, then I mean, it would just make the dreads a little bit bigger and less so much on your head. So if you're one of the people who don't like a whole bunch of dreads, then I advise you go look for a sponge, bigger holes. And I don't know if it's gonna work the same as this one, but yeah, I mean, you guys could do that. Let me know how it goes. And yeah, another thing I wanted to talk about is this is, I think, is very critical. So with dreads, right? You know, I used to have hand twisted dreads like from start, and I realized it would always get fizzy. I know some of you guys out there understand that when your hair gets fizzy, it's just like you always want to wear like a do-rag or something. You're just like, you're getting gassed because you're like, that ain't no dreads, you know, other people flaming you and stuff. But hear me out, when you get dreads with the sponge, right, you could just twist them whenever. I could just twist them right now, right? So if they start frizzing up just a little bit, right, you could go ahead and just start twisting them up. And that's why I really like doing it with this, because I mean, you don't have to worry about them coming undone, right? And like, let's say you're like just chilling and you notice, hey, some of these dreads are getting like unknotted. You just go get your sponge, twist, easy as that. And I really like that part about using the sponge. I think it's perfect. But yeah, you guys let me know if you guys think that's a good thing or a bad thing. One thing though, I do want to say this, is if you do over twist, especially since the dreads are smaller, what will happen is at the root, it will start to, so what happens is, since your dreads are small, they're gonna start thinning up at the roots of them. And honestly, you don't want that happening, because that it just makes your dreads fall out. You do not want that happening. It happened a little bit, like I said, back on my other time doing my hair stuff. It's just not something you want. Like I said, you could double them up if you really want to, but to avoid doing that, just really really sponge when you feel like it's necessary, you know. Like I said, do it whenever, but like when you feel it's necessary, because you know, you don't want to. So you know, after knowing that stuff, that's like, I'd say that's like the most important stuff that I've noticed. Last time I did my dreads, like I noticed them a little bit, so this time around I was a little bit more careful, and I do notice a difference. And So if you're doing this, keep that in mind. Okay. So now here's one last thing that I think, you know, could really help you out. When you're sometimes you go to sleep and you wake up and your dreads are like, for example, sometimes mine will like in the back, right? They would come up like that and stay matted on the bed. And it's not fun. Or sometimes like you'll just be laying down and you want to play with your hair, so you do that. And you know, sometimes keeping them down can be a problem. Okay. Now, one thing I've noticed is when you overwater your hair, what happens is they start to stiffen up and it makes the dreads like really stick out. Okay. I'm not saying don't wash your hair. I'm not saying don't get your hair wet. But what I am saying is to get the best results for like keeping your hair down, do what you can to like not get it too wet, right? You want to just like moisturize and like wash it around the same time, and then boom, you're good. Just take your hand, something slight. Anyways, really, I just want to give you guys those tips, because I know when I went around this time, I kept those in mind and it really made a big difference. So I want you guys to know that too. I hope you guys stay tuned. School is getting really busy, especially since it's my junior year, but you already know basketball season coming up. Hopefully I can start a vlogging and stuff. That's gonna be fun. Anyways, I'll catch you guys in the next video. Thank you.